Last week, the front page of the Franklin County News had a story on the large number of applications for liquor licenses prior to the government's proposed alcohol reform bill coming in. There was an immediate outcry from my constituents, deeply concerned that the Franklin area, particularly around Pukekohe, has enough liquor outlets already. I have since replied and pointed out to them that the proposed bill does include the opportunity for local community boards and local communities to have a strong say in any new licenses. The general philosophy will be that licenses will be harder to get and easier to lose. When the Law Commission sat on this issue, the major areas that it felt would minimise harm included access to alcohol, age, advertising, marketing, and a variety of other areas. Access is certainly one of the major ones that the community feels that they can participate in. And so the question is that it won't come soon enough for our local community. Right now, the Auckland Council say they're really powerless to turn down an application that is legitimate, although there is a fair feeling that they, many of them are opportunistic and that the applicants are really wanting to make a bob. So the viewers bring on the bill. Over the weekend, the National Party has had an incredibly successful annual conference. One of the major issues was the partial privatisation of the energy companies and further sell down of Air New Zealand. Once again, the arguments for this were extremely strong, with the thought being that not only would this assist in balancing the books, but also the funds would go to a national infrastructure fund to help build schools and hospitals and other vital infrastructure that would otherwise require overseas borrowing. What was of great interest was that on the Saturday, when it was relatively fine, there were a number of protesters there, probably a couple of hundred. They were outnumbered by police and didn't make very much of a mark, but on the Sunday, when it was wet, only a handful turned up. There's no doubt that they are fair weather protesters and that it looks as though this issue is now starting to be won by its proponents, the governments. It is a win for the government, and I believe a win for the people of New Zealand.